step. What can figure it out? That's how it chooses you.
Hello, Teresa.
Hello, Claire. You have a beautiful pattern of shadows on your face.
That's right. We don't normally record this time of day, so you're getting glistening afternoon Claire action.
Glowing Western light Claire.
Also sweating her balls off Claire.
Yeah. Get that nice undertit sweat. Oh, that's the best. Yeah. You got to tuck the t-shirt up under there to absorb, I find. It's quite helpful.
Welcome, everyone, to It Chooses You, Smidgen Edition.
Smidgen Edition is here.
We're here giving you a little taste of something good.
Taste of something good, usually media related. Often something we have both watched and want to tell each other about.
That's right. Because it's the weekend, damn it. We should enjoy ourselves.
Just a little Sunday morning. Have your coffee. Listen to the smidgen. Ah, so nice. What am I going to watch later after I've done the things that make my life good? Like caring for my children and partner and house and all the things people have to do every day.
What's going on?
Yeah, we talked a little bit about the week I've had, a couple weeks I've had. So after I'd made that phone call I told you about, I was in my kitchen with my computer, like cooking and having something on in the background to listen to while I'm cooking. And I made the food and I made the plate and I was carrying the plate in one hand and the computer in the other. And I took a turn in my kitchen and bumped a wall or did something and almost dropped my computer.
Oh, no.
I did a bobble thing and I caught it, but I caught it like point first right against my fucking mouth.
Oh, my God.
Let me get super close here.
I can see it. Yeah. You've got a bump, scratchy.
Yeah. It hurt so badly. I've never been hit in the face before. And I'm really grateful for that, because turns out it really hurts.
Yeah.
Not a fan.
You won't be joining Fight Club anytime soon.
No, absolutely not. But we knew that. We've been talking about couch versus mountain long enough. I think people are hip to the fact that neither one of us are Fight Club kind of people. But it popped me right in the lip, and I thought I was going to pass out, but I didn't, because it hurts so bad. I didn't drop anything. I didn't hurt any dog. I didn't hurt any property. All of the pain of the event was focused right on my mouth, right?
Yeah.
And so I basically just had to breathe through the pain for like 5 minutes before I could even think about opening my mouth. It hurt that much. And I was like, just wait it out. That's all you can do. If you touch it, it will be worse. You don't know if you've punctured your lip. You don't know bacteria. Like, you're in a lot of pain. You're not going to make good decisions. Just wait. So I just sat in the most pain I've been in a while, waiting. And I was like, okay, my teeth are intact. Score. My gums are not hurting as much as they were when it first happened. Score. Don't think I've damaged anything permanently. I have a really nice bruise, and I cut into my lip very significantly with my teeth. But I'm okay now. I just feel my lips are a little swollen and they're very chapped because there's a lot of like congealed blood and stuff happening. So,
oh shit.
I'm just saying, like, just be careful how you speak, because the universe might cause you to pop yourself in the face with your computer if you do not speak in ways that are approved of.
Yeah, in your integrity.
If I'm not in my integrity, I may hurt myself unconsciously, but directly. As a result of it. But also, I was so proud of myself because I was telling Mike about it and I was like, it was never a question that I was going to drop the computer. Like, my face is expendable. Nobody sees it anyway. We're still wearing masks. Nobody's going to see this thing as it's healing. It's totally hidden. My computer is not expendable. I cannot buy a new one right now and I require it. So I saved the computer. I was very proud of myself.
You were very clear on your priorities in that moment.
Like, my amygdala was there for me. It was a split second decision. There was no reasoning. It was like, something's falling, catch it. It doesn't matter how.
And you didn't even drop the food.
Didn't even drop the food.
That's incredible. Probably couldn't eat it after your mouth was hurting so
bad.
No,
I didn't eat for about a day. But, you know, all fine now. I was like, oh, I guess I'm not going to eat this. Yes, but it's better now. So that also happened this week. It's been lots happened this week.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you're okay.
Thanks. Me too.
Well, you know what else happened this week? It was my birthday.
Yes. Happy birthday.
Thank you. My people came through in terms of books.
Oh.
I was gifted the most wonderful set of books from a couple different people that all have a thread in common. So today on Smidgen, we will be talking about spring book recommendations for witches.
Yes! That's such a great topic. Oh, so good. I feel like I want to go get my witch books. Show you mine.
These are just a few recommendations of delightful things you might read leading into the spring here.
Nice.
The first book I received is by Chani Nicholas. It's her book, You Were Born for This. For anyone who doesn't know, Chani is an LA-based astrologer, and you can actually get your chart done on her website for free.
Yeah.
But if you want to interpret any of that, you have to have her book, You Were Born for This.
Yeah.
And so the book gives an explanation for what the different aspects of your chart mean, and it gives you a sense of what's going on as you personally make your way through the world.
Yeah.
And for the last few years, I haven't really delved into self-help or any kind of self-reflection literature at all. It's been a while, but I really found her take helpful.
Yeah, she's really aware of power structures in a way I find pleasant.
And her writing style is personal, but it's also really profound, right?
Yeah. And one of the things I like best is that she writes, it's just kind of things you might think about in your life. It's not as heavily weighted toward the mathy, trine, sextant kind of astrology language that I don't enjoy. It's really like, think about your relationships. Is everything you're doing serving you? This is a great time to really look at that.
Yeah, I feel like the time for really specific horoscopes of like a financial surprise will greet you on the 15th is over. Like, yeah. We're done with that. I feel like the best astrology now and the most cutting edge astrology, if I can say that, is all about themes that you might observe working in your life.
Yeah, it's basically like I think of it as a pretty, like neat, fun pop psychology session. I'm like, oh, my pop psychology email's here. Let me see about this thing.
Everyone, you can visit her website, chaninicholas.com, and get your birth chart done. And then we can meet back here and talk about it. The second book I am recommending today is Tasia Kitaskaya's Literary Witches, A Celebration of Magical Women Writers.
Nice.
We've mentioned Tasia before on the podcast. She's the one who wrote the series of Ask Baba Yaga books that we've referenced in the past. Literary Witches is a short compendium of female writers from the perspective of what each person's particular genius or brand of magic is.
Nice!
Each entry is just a page, so it's just a little taste.
Yeah.
And it's a really cool way to find some writers you might not have heard of. There are some that you would expect, like Virginia Woolf, Octavia Butler, and Isabel Allende. But then there are some lesser-known writers in here that she's introduced me to, like Angela Carter.
You didn't know Angela Carter?
No.
I'm so sorry, Claire.
I know.
Oh.
Maria Sabina, Sandra Cisneros, and Jamaica Kincaid.
Sandra Cisneros and Jamaica Kincaid are also both just amazing. I feel like I've been a negligent friend. I didn't know you didn't know them.
I feel like this is Teresa in book form. Like, I can't always rely on you. I knew reading this list to you that you would know these people, of course. But I didn't, so now I have like a little reference book where I can go like, oh, I'm really interested in that person.
Oh, that's cool.
As we know, Tasia's writing style is deep and dark and mm-hmm. whimsical and mm-hmm. true. Mm-hmm. She's absolutely wonderful. I also just found out that they've made a tarot deck based on the book called The Literary Witch's Oracle.
Oh.
So if you want to get super witchy.
I mean, that sounds like something that we should just have as like, that's a business expense.
I think so.
Like, that's clearly just a business expense, Claire.
True. The next book I wanted to tell you about is by V.E. Schwab. It's called The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue.
Oh, I don't know it.
So this is a novel about a young woman in 18th century France who makes a deal with a deity. Am I saying that weird? Camera.
Where is the bébé, David? Alexis, where is the bébé? I say deity, but other people who are fancy say deity. So you can say deity or deity.
I've never in my life said deity. All right. She makes a deal with the deity for eternal life.
Uh-huh.
However, the price she pays is that no one will remember her.
I mean, the price she pays is that she has to fucking live forever.
That's a price, too.
The price she pays is that everyone she ever loved dies. And there's no point in making new friends because they're just going to die in 80 years anyway. That's the price she pays. Okay, sorry.
I'm a bit into the book, and it's a really dark fairy tale set in various places and time periods. It's really heartbreaking. Her writing style is lush and vivid, and I can't wait to finish reading it.
Well, I'm very excited when the war is over for a book trade.
Oh, yeah, it's happening. The final book I'd like to tell you all about is by Claire Saffitz. It's a cookbook called Dessert Person.
Yeah, Claire Saffitz is my third Claire, if I'm honest.
She's wonderful. She's a pastry chef. She wrote a cookbook. It contains recipes for everything from a revamped version of confetti cake.
Mm-hmm. I saw that video. It's really good.
To pistachio linzer tart and pigs in a brioche blanket.
Pigs in a brioche blanket. Did she use Vienna sausages?
No.
Damn it. Damn it.
And I have to tell you all that this morning I made her maple walnut sticky buns, and they were wonderful. The dough is light and fluffy and not too rich, and the buns aren't too sweet, and they have a complex flavor that comes from orange zest and cardamom. Mm. Her style is that she tends to put a cool New York spin on classic French and American baking. I highly recommend you all check it out. She's fantastic.
She's great.
Those are my book recommendations for witches.
Say them one more time.
So we've got Chani Nicholas, You Were Born for This.
Yeah.
Tasia Kitaiskaya's Literary Witches, A Celebration of Magical Women Writers. The third book is V.E. Schwab's The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue.
Yeah.
And Claire Saffitz's Dessert Person.
Nice.
Check them all out. Get your read on, everybody. What else are you going to do? Work?
Work? No. It's springtime. It's time to go outside.
And read a book in the hammock.
Yeah. Oh, hammock time is coming soon. That's very exciting. Okay, great. We'll leave you with that image. Reading on a beautiful spring morning with sun filtering through twiggy trees that don't have leaves yet. You're going to read these books in a hammock or in a park.
Thank you all so much for listening. Don't forget to rate, like, and subscribe to our podcast. This has been It Chooses You with Claire Patton and Teresa Sparks, and we will see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Testing? Great. Thank you for listening to It Chooses You. Your hosts are Teresa Sparks and Claire Patton. Our theme song is by Bobby Dart. If you'd like to get in touch with us, drop us an email at itchoosesyoupodcast@gmail.com.